Okay, good morning to one and all. This is Dr. Mahesh
M.
Wanjeri, Assistant Professor from Department of Management Studies, SDM College of Engineering and Technology, Dharwad. Okay. So today we all have organized here to listen to our guest of the day, Ms. Hemani C.H. Okay, so I really feel proud to introduce our guest of the day, Ms. Hemani, okay, who was my student of the Department of Management Studies, SDM College of Engineering and Technology, Dharwad. So we teachers always feel, okay, proud when our students come to meet us and they say, sir, I'm working in this company since so many months, years. See, that is the purpose of a teacher. That was the objective of the college. So it really gives me immense pleasure to introduce our guest of the day, Ms. Hemani. So Ms. Hemani is working as apparel department manager in Vishal Megamart Hypermarket in Bengaluru. So Ms. Hemani was a student of 2017-19 batch. Okay, and she chose her specialization as marketing. And definitely I would like to speak about her college days. During college days, she was, a really dedicated, punctual, hardworking and honest girl. Okay, so one can make out that, no doubt, okay, she has continued to work in the company. Okay, so in fact many students joined the same organization, but many of them have discontinued. Hemani is the only girl who has continued to work in the organization. So there is a saying, when the going gets tough, only the tough gets going. Okay, so the kind of personality and behavior she exhibited in the college, that was exactly what was required to sustain in the corporate world. So Ms. Hemani will be talking to us today about her selection process in Vishal Megamart, her induction and training, her job profile and day-to-day operations, as well as her performance appraisal. So she has completed 1 year and 2 months as of now. So we think this introduction, so I request Ms. Hemani to address our students on the topic, role of department manager in a hypermarket. Just a minute. Yeah, I request all the students to pin her video onto your screen so that you can see her on full screen. Ms. Hemani, welcome to the online guest lecture, and I really feel proud. So I request you to address our students on the topic.
Yeah, am I audible, sir?
Yeah, you are audible.
Yeah, well, good morning, everyone. I'm Hemani. It's my honor, more than a pleasure, to be a part of this session today. Today, I would like to tell you how exactly the department managers play a role in hypermarket. Before I begin with, I would like to introduce my organization to you, everyone. So, the Vishal Megamart was founded by Ramchandra Agarwal in 1986. After a few years, he incurred huge financial losses and bad debts. Because of that, he sold out the company to the Air Plaza Retail Holdings. Now, the Vishal operates under Air Plaza Retail Holdings. And the CEO of my company is Dr. Gunender Kapoor. And we have our head office in Gurgaon, Haryana. So today we have totally 388 stores across the country, and we target middle income level people where majority of the Indian population lies in. And we have three departments in our store. One is apparels and general merchandise and FMCG, where the apparels contribution is 60% and general merchandise contribution is 20% and FMCG contribution is 20%. Yeah, when I talk about the revenue of the particular company, each and every store will generate a sale of up to 1.2 to 1.5 crore per month. I'm calculating in terms of 1 month like that. So the revenue and sale generation will depend upon the square feet of that particular store. Right now, the where I'm working, that particular square, that store square feet is of 25,000. And now we are generating the sale of 1.5 to 1.7 crore per month. Its sale depends on the seasons and the type of the square feet and the kind of environment that store is being located. So yeah, that's a small introduction regarding my organization. And let me tell you about how I have undergone the interview process in the Vishal, how I had attended the interview process of a Vishal. So they have conducted totally 3 rounds in the interview. So one is group discussion followed by a written test, and another one is the final round is personal interview. In the group discussion, so they have given us a random current affairs topic wherein we have to discuss regarding that particular topic. Hope you know better how exactly the group discussions will happen. And the next round is followed by a written test wherein they have posed some of the basic aptitude questions which normally everybody can attend. Those are not so complicated also. Like the questions like ratios and proportions like that, some of the basic questions they have been posed as. So after the candidates have been shortlisted, they have to attend for the personal round, that is a personal interview, where the face-to-face interaction with the HR will happen. You know, the scene goes like this in the personal interview. How I had attended is like, the HR is sitting in the cabin and I just opened the door and I was like about to hand over my resume to him. And he said, no, I don't want your resume, just keep it with yourself and you can have a seat. And I was like, okay, thank you. And he asked me to introduce myself, and I introduced myself. And the next question he asked is like, why you wanted to join retail sector? And I answered him like, sir, I'm an active and enthusiastic girl. I always look for a challenging job and I don't want to restrict myself to one particular desk job. And moreover, retail is an emerging sector and I think it's the best platform for me to prove myself, and I'm expecting a very good career growth in the retail sector. So this is how I have answered. For this reply, so he have answered, questioned me again, saying that how can you say that retail is an emerging sector and how can you expect that you get a better growth in the retail sector? So this is how he questioned me. And then I replied, sir, in India, the penetration of organized retail sector is just 7%. When compared to foreign countries, it is 93%. It is totally a vice versa of the scenario what Indian and foreign countries are facing now. So, you know, imagine if it grown for 7% to 10%, 15% like that, there will be n number of employment opportunities will be generated for the freshers. And even for the demand for the experienced individuals will be very vast. So this is, so whatever the Mahesh sir has been taught in the retail management class, the same thing I have been copy pasted in that interview, literally. Yeah. And he was like, yeah. Okay, fine then. For that, my reply, then he questioned me again, like, what if I reject you now? Then I replied, sir, okay, I look for some other opportunity, but let me know before rejecting, but let me know the reason behind you reject me, such that I can improve myself better in the next coming interviews. So this is the last question he posed me. And yeah, he said, okay, thank you. You can leave now. I'll announce the results later. And this is the most awaiting moment for all the students. Out of 230, totally 230 students have been attended for that particular interview on that day. Out of 230 students, they have shortlisted only 20 candidates. Out of 20, 15 were male, only 5 were female. So I'm the one among those five females. So we are very happy that we got selected, and we have said to our professors that I got selected in the Vishal Mega Mart and all. Finally, a dream come true that I wanted to join in a retail sector. So finally, there ends the matter. When I was in a third semester MBA, I got placed in the Vishal, and after completion of my fourth semester, I have joined the Vishal. They have given us a joining date. Like July 16th, 2019, I have joined the Vishal. They called us for the training purpose and we had gone to Bangalore, and they have given us a very luxury life accommodation. They have given us a very nice hotel accommodation. So previous day, July 15th, we have reached the Bangalore night, we have reached and we had gone to that hotel. And the next day, July 16th, we went to the one particular store, training store, we had gone over there. And during the first day, our joining formalities and induction program was done. In the joining formalities, they have verified all our documents, and those documents are being uploaded in the portal, and those documents are being approved by the HRs. Then our joining is being done and followed by the induction program. In the induction program, we are being introduced to all the management over there, and area manager have come and he talked very nicely and he motivated us, and we felt very happy on that particular day. They treated us very nicely during the first day. Yeah, in the first day, joining formalities and induction program was done. And the next day onwards, the training begins. The crucial part of, this is very crucial part. From in the training, what happened is like the trainer used to take 4 to 5 hours of class per day. And after that, after the class, whatever he's been taking, then we are being moved to the floor. And he used to tell us, observe whatever I have been said in the class with the PPT. Are those things are being implemented in the floor or not? Just go and observe, he used to tell. Simultaneously, we used to get subject knowledge. At the same time, we used to see the practical orientation in the floor also. So this is how our training used to go on. So in the training, what happens is like they used to assign a work us a lot. So much of work they will give us. We feel like we the students, we are being spoon-fed in the MBA during MBA. But right now when we are assigned so much of work, what we'll feel like, oh my God, what I'm doing? These people are assigning so much of work for us. We can't sustain and we'll feel like quitting. So many people fail during the training itself. What will happen is like they'll quit immediately and they can't work. Intentionally, our trainers will assign and give you so much of work to test his or her performance, whether she or he can work in the sustain in the retail sector or not. They'll test you a lot. That doesn't mean that the same work, whatever you are getting in the training session, will be same work you are getting in the, your job location. It is not like that. During training session, you will be getting so much of work. Wherein after you get a job location, you can work freely. In the training, so what he used to teach is like, normally when we see a table, we'll name it as a table, we call it as a table. But in the case of retail terminology, it is called as bed rack. There will be a number of retail terminologies will be there, like we'll call for bed racks, end caps, you'll be knowing, and gondolas, 5 feet gondolas, 7 feet gondolas, and waterfalls, pin hooks, peg hooks, or horizontal. There will be a number of things and naming for the fixtures. And he used to teach us how to display the merchandises on those fixtures. Since from the basic to the reports handling, he'll be teaching us. And you know, they make us to work with the associates also. They used to give us a cloth and say, tell us to clean the fixtures. Unless and we feel like, array, what is there? We have studied MBA, but now we are cleaning the fixtures with the cloth. We literally said him like that, sir, what is this work, your kind of work you are assigning me? And he used to reply us, unless and until you work ground the level, you cannot lead your managerial role. Unless and until you work like that, what are all the problems and complications your subordinates face, you cannot know. So that is the reason I make you to work like that. You have to work. If you could not work, just leave the company now itself and we don't bother about anything. So this is how he used to tell us. And even in the during training, he used to conduct a surprise test. So there the surprise test he have conducted, I think 5 to 6 surprise tests will be conducting. And end of the training period, like we had undergone training for 2 months in the Bangalore Tipasandra, which is there in Indranagar. At the end of the day, training, he used to announce the results and our scoring and all. At the end of the training day, we have been assigned one job location. Like I have given us a job location, like in the Bangalore itself, I got job location. Whereas my friends got Ballari, somebody got Hubli, somebody got Shimoga, like that. So it is most exciting moments. For 2 months, we'll be working without any week offs. I think one day I fell sick. So that is the one day I have taken off, that's it. For 2 weeks or 2 months, you don't get any offs. You have to work like anything. They ask me so much of work. And during that time, many people quit and many people feel that it is not our perfect job to work like that. But it is not like that, guys. They test you a lot during the training. That doesn't mean that the same kind of work you'll be having after you got your job location. So this is how our training period goes on. Finally, I got job location in Bangalore itself. And the next day, I had moved to my job location where my independent role will start. So I have moved to there will be a separate store manager will be there for me, assistant store manager will be there. So I'll tell you how exactly my organization structure in the store level will be going on. So one first, the higher authority will be a store manager. Under him, there will be assistant store manager. Under him, we three department managers will be there. So department manager for apparels, department manager for general merchandise, and the department manager for FMCG. Below us, there will be a senior associates will be there. Under them, there will be a CSAs. So this is how the store level organization structure will be there. So after I be moved to my job location, I'm welcomed by my store manager and his assistant store manager, and I'm being introduced to all the store team. And here my actual independent role starts, being a department manager. The entire 60% contribution of the apparels is there in my hand. I was like, I feel very proud, and now my job roles and responsibilities got tightened, and I have to enlighten everything. So basically, what are all the roles and responsibilities I'll be handling is like, I am being a department manager, I'm responsible for handling the customers and handling the staff, and have in terms of recruitment, I have to hire the staff and I have to train them. At the same time, and I am responsible for handling and maintaining the standard display patterns. I'll tell you what exactly the standard display pattern means. So there will be a guidelines from the company saying that you need to display the merchandises in this pattern only. For example, in order to display the t-shirts, we'll be having the standard display pattern. Like, first you need to display round neck t-shirts, followed by V-neck t-shirts, followed by hemline neck t-shirts, followed by collar neck t-shirts. This is the SDP and the guidelines from the company which we need to follow. So in the same way, we need to follow the guidelines. There will be a plan for the entire department, and there will be a plan for the entire store. So whatever the standard display patterns that store communicates to you, you need to display and maintain the same thing. There should not be any deviations in that particular display patterns. So this is what about the standard display patterns. And I'm responsible for handling the zero sale reports. Zero sale reports in the sense, there are some of the articles and the merchandises, they won't be get sold out even after 1 month of one month, 2 months, like that. You'll be getting a communication from the HO, head office, the mail, saying that these are the articles from your store, so in respect to department, those are not moving since from the 1 month. So you have to take, so during that time, I have to take some necessary plan action. What I have to do, let's say V-neck round, let me give an example. Round neck t-shirt or V-neck t-shirt in a month, it is not moving since from the past 1 month. Zero sale, not even a single piece is being sold out. So what action I have to take, being a department manager, is like, first I have to check whether that V-neck t-shirt is being available in the floor or not. If it is available, why it is not moving? If it is not moving, whether the proper signage or properly the promotion is being communicated or not. If it is communicated, whether that is been visible to the customers or not. Proper visibility is there or not. So those are all the necessary actions. If it is not properly visible, change that location and move that location to the prominent one, prominent location, such that the customer can see that particular product and they can pick that. So this is the action plan I have to take when it comes to zero sale reports. So the next is like, I have to handle stock sufficiency report. One thing is like, stock sufficiency report is like, I need to ensure 100% stock availability. I cannot, when a particular customer asks me, show me this one, that one, I cannot say that, no, this is not available in our store, this is not available. We should ensure that everything is being properly segregated. And if there is no stock, we have to put a requirement for the category person saying that so and so stock is not available in our departments, so kindly send a stock. So stock sufficiency report goes in line with the requirement of the stock. So I have to talk to the one particular category person and tell him that so and so stock is not there, please send a stock to him. I need to follow up regarding that. That is how the stock sufficiency report will tell us. So, and then I'm responsible for handling the shrink. Shrink is a major complicated task which each and every manager, department manager, not only department manager, even as assistant store manager and store manager will face and feel difficult to handle it. Why? Because there will be a, even in the researches, there will be a major shrink happens internally. So shrink will happen internally, externally, and there are many ways how the shrink will happen. And we being a department manager, I have to train the staff how to tackle the customer. How to tackle the customers if they are so suspected customers like that. So there are, we implement pin tagging policies and all to reduce the shrink and all. We implement so many tactics so in order to control the shrink. And I am responsible for loss and prevention manager. So he'll be, there will be an RLP coming over and asking me, hey Mani, in the system it is showing that 1,000 pieces of the jeans, but physically you are having only 700 pieces. Then where are the rest 300 pieces? But in that case, I'm responsible for telling him where the 300 pieces have gone. I cannot say that, sir, that is a shrink and all. So we have to tell whether those jeans have been damaged or else that has been actually the shrink had happened. So I'm responsible for handling, total answering for him. So the shrink plays a very important role, literally a very complicated task which each and every department manager will face. And then I'm responsible for handling the customers and grievance handling. Grievance, normally what will happen is like when a promotion is not been properly executed, the customers will like, you know, there is a question saying that yeah, there will be, there is a buy one get one offer, but yeah, but when we go to the billing counter, it is not showing buy one get one, the MRP it is billing. So what is it, this kind of complications will occur. So being a department manager, we have to ensure 100% promotion implementation is being implemented. There should not be any cross communication that should not disturb the customers. So one thing that we have to ensure, so finally whatever it has been happened, finally the customers are the god. We have to enlighten the customers by providing all the facilities, and we have to make the customers loyal, and we have to retain the customers like that. And I have to train the staff such that how they have to politely speak with the customers like that, how they have to tackle in the difficult situations. These are all some of the basic things I'll be training to the staff over there. And I am responsible for, you know, my reporting authorities, ASM. I'll be, whatever the complications I'll be feeling, I'll be just telling him. So he'll be explaining him a lot. So this is how, these are some of the major roles I'm discussing regarding department role, how the department managers will play a role in hypermarkets. So coming to my day-to-day operations, so normally the store will open at 8 o'clock. There will be a two department managers will be there in the opening, and the closing there will be gents department managers will be there. The store will open at 8 o'clock and closing time will be at 10 o'clock. From 8 o'clock to 10, morning 10 o'clock, there won't be any customer entry. Until those two hours will be meant for cleaning of the store, and we need to ensure all the promotions have been implemented, and we have to, you know, cleaning and everything. We have to, before the customer entry, we have to make sure the store is been totally ready for the sale. So after the customer entry begins, so then I have to cross check the sale, hourly sale I need to, you know, target, and I need to communicate my hourly sale to the customers, and I have to assign the targets to the customers, and you know, to the my staff. I have to tell him that yeah, it's already 12 o'clock and your department is been reached only just 50,000, so you have to focus more. Come on, let's focus more. Why the sale is very less, just focus on the store. Just try to talk to the customers and communicate what are all the offers you are having. Just I need to assign some of the targets to the my staff, and they just push the sale like that. And after that, what will happen, normally hourly wise I need to trace the sale, I need to communicate with them. If any complications occur, being a department manager, I have to lead that particular problem. And even in the cash point, if there is so much of crowd, being a department manager, you have to be ready to build the products also. That has then mean that no, that is not my job, that is the job which is being doing by the CSAs, I cannot do such tasks like that. No, you have to build the products also when there is so much of crowd such that, because customers cannot have patience to stand in the queue, so much of for long queues like that. So in order to feel the customers very comfortable, even you have to do a task of the CSA also during that particular time. You have to build the products also to make them feel convenient. So this is how some of the my roles and responsibilities I would like to quote about you. You know, if I am not reaching the targets, my store manager will ask me, so Hemani, what is your today's target is like 3 lakh. So, but you have not reached the particular target. So what are your actions plans for tomorrow? Then I'll be saying that, sir, yeah, yesterday was so and so, this crowd was not, so walk-ins was not so much happened. So today I'll cover the backlogs and also I'm responsible for each and everything. So if the targets is not meeting, the he'll question me, then I have to question for the ask for the staff of my staff and everything. So this is how the day-to-day operations will happen. There are being a department manager, your role will be a very crucial. Every day will be a challenging task. I'm telling you, if you join the retail, you'll enjoy the task. But because daily you'll meet a number of customers on the floor, you, daily a new promotions will be there. You'll be implementing those promotions. You'll talk to the customers. When you are feel bored, you can around say handle the reports, work on the reports. That you do, people feel that retail is something which does not suit for the girls like that. But I'm telling you, it's a very challenging job, which one everybody can enjoy. But everything what you have, what should have is like that passionate to work. That is what I can tell you. Please do join retail sector. Don't think that I'm a girl, I cannot work in the retail sector like that. I'm literally telling you, retail is a fantastic platform wherein you can prove yourself if you are passionate enough. Okay, that is what I would like to tell you and I wanted to highlight it today. So, and coming to my, so this is what is my, a few job roles and responsibilities. If I, there are many, if I tell you being a student, you may not understand some, there are few things that I have highlighted you, which you can understand, that's it. So this is what my few job roles and responsibilities. Now I would like to tell you about my performance appraisal. So performance appraisal is being done every quarterly. So initially there will be a self-appraisal wherein I have to grade myself on that particular quarter. So there will be a questions like what you have done in this particular quarter, like that. They'll be posing some of the questions, then I have to log into my portal and I have to type whatever I have been done in this particular quarter. Okay. And after that, you know, next that my appraisal is been whatever I have been graded myself, that is been reviewed by my store manager. And then he will be finally give a grading for me. And that is being viewed by the HO people. If my performance appraisal is being graded very nicely, then I'll be immediately promoted. And everything is there in the hands of SM. So kindly maintain a very good relationship with your subordinates at the same time with your higher authority. So you should not show reluctant behavior towards your subordinates and the same time your higher authority. Maintain a good friendly relationship and work. Your work environment should be homely. Unless and until you create such kind of environment, you cannot work freely in that workplace. Okay. So maintain or try to maintain a very good relationship with everyone and try to be polite enough with your subordinates at the same time and your higher authority. Respect them, don't give counter answers and counter effects to your higher authorities. Finally, you will be put in a very complicated situation. So this is what I would like to tell you. This is how my performance appraisals was done. And finally, what is regarding my future plans. So, right now I am very much happy that I have I am working in the sector which I wanted to be, which is my dream actually. I'm in a retail sector. I'm very much happy today working in a retail sector, and I cannot even tell you how happy I am, but literally I'm very happy. So, and I wanted to continue in the retail sector, and how much I know. If you ask me how much I know in the retail sector is just a 10% out of 100%. What I know is just a 10%. Retail is like an ocean, one cannot imagine the depth of it. But I'm trying to learn new things from my higher authority day by day, and within next 2 years I'm trying to become a store manager at least. So everything store manager at least, and then followed by area manager and zonal manager. There will be a growth, there will be an abundant growth in the retail sector. Please do join retail sector, I'm telling you. And I'm feeling very happy. Daily I'll encounter so many challenges. I love working in the retail, and that is what I would like to tell you. So yeah, that is my future plans. I wanted to continue in the retail sector. That's it. Yeah, thank you. I think this much is enough. Yeah.
Okay, thank you, Hemani.
Yes, sir. Hello?
Yeah, just give us a minute.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Okay, so thank you, Hemani. So for a few minutes I thought as if though I was there in a hypermarket. I could visualize, okay, when you especially spoke about the day-to-day operations and your role and responsibilities, I was just feeling that I was in a hypermarket. So I was visualizing what actually you are saying. Okay, so it was very effective, and definitely it will help our students who are planning their career in the retail sector. Okay.
Yes.
So, and definitely I wish you to see you in the position of a store manager, okay? Okay, around 2 years.
Thank you so much.
Where I will invite you once again, okay?
Yeah, sure, for sure, sir.
So now, we'll go on for interaction session. So where students may have some doubts or questions, okay? So, students, now the platform is open for your questions. So you can attempt to ask the question orally. So if there is any connectivity issue, you can type the question in the chat box. Okay,
yeah.
And when you ask your question, please turn on your video and unmute your audio. Yeah. Students, your questions now.
Good morning, ma'am.
Yeah,
good morning.
I'm audio, ma'am.
Yeah, tell me.
What's the best thing about working for this company, ma'am?
So best thing working for this, you are asking about Vishal, right? Or the entire retail?
Yes,
you are
ma'am.
Asking about Vishal.
No,
you are
Vishal
asking.
Ma'am.
Yeah,
yes.
The thing in Vishal is like everybody know that today we are 388 stores across. We have 388 stores across the country. Am I audible, Maruf?
Yeah, ma'am. No,
yeah. So today we have 388 stores across the country. Okay. So now what the thing, the best thing working in a Vishal is like for the freshers, you'll be getting not so much of hectic work will be there. And you know, if for each and every, when I was talking with the Mahesh sir, I said him that sir, today we have 386 stores across the country. By within a week, again two stores have been set up.
Yeah.
So you know, even in the Hubli itself, two stores are there.
Yeah.
In the Dharwad, one store is there, and even in the Gadag and even in Belgaum, in each and every taluk, we are focusing to set up one particular store each and everywhere. So if you join the Vishal, you will be having n number of opportunities. Like, you know, your growth will be, if you prove yourself, you are being moved to one particular store, you get a better opportunity for your career growth.
Yes,
like that you are moved to one particular. Yeah, Maruf is performing well, let him move to a new store which is been setting up in a Dharwad. Maybe after a few days a new store may come up in the Dharwad. Yeah, Maruf is proving better, let me promote him to his native only as a department manager to the Dharwad itself. Yeah, they'll immediately promote you. And what you have to do is like just, and the compared to other retailers, Vishal is paying high. So one thing is like I even placed in Reliance also out of the campus, but the Reliance people used to pay me only 18K. After that, some people said me that in the Reliance, like that for the freshers, you know, what will happen, there will be a hectic kind of work will be there. People thought of quitting it like that. Just because of my pay, I joined the Vishal, literally I'm telling, but I have done a very good decision. Right now, I'm getting 3.25 package, but Reliance is paying only 2.8K. for the freshers. I had gone in terms of salary pay also, I had went through, and majorly I focused like Vishal is setting up, it's emerging like anything, and we have a number of stores have been setting up frequently, a number of stores are coming up. I thought that I'll be getting a better opportunity wherein later I can move towards my, even in my native also, my native is Gangavati, a new store is been set up, and my area manager asked me to, if you wanted to go for your native, you can go and take the transfer. I said him, no, I wanted to just explore myself a lot, so I wanted to be there in the Bangalore itself. That is, even I got an opportunity to go to my native also, but I have rejected that. I'll stay back in the Bangalore itself. So if you join the Bangalore, if you join the Vishal, this is what I'm telling you, you'll get a very good pay when compared to other retailers, and you'll be, for the freshers, it's the best platform. You don't get any hectic kind of work, will be there. So that is what I would like to tell you. You can better learn. So any other questions, Maru?
Yeah, thank you, Hemani. There are two questions in chat box.
Yeah.
Thank you, Maru.
Thank you, Maru.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Thank
you.
Yeah. Yes,
thank you, sir.
Yeah, Sudha Siddhappa. So the question is like, what are some everyday challenges you face in your profession? So the everyday challenges, yeah, am I clear to everyone?
Yes, Hemani, your voice is clear.
Yeah. So what are the everyday challenges you face in your profession? The challenges is like, you know, grievances, one thing I'll tell you. So because what will happen is like, when the promotions are being communicated in the mail, I will be giving those promotions to implement to the staff. Somewhere I'll be got busy on the some other work, they fail to implement those kind of promotions. What will happen is like, you know, there is a buy one get one offer for a t-shirt. They fail to remove the old offer which is running is buy one get one offer. Then we'll be getting a communication from the HO saying that remove buy one get one offer and sell it in an MRP. So, but my staff, what they'll do, they forget or by mistakenly they fail to remove that signage and implement the new promo. So the customer, when they approach, they are by looking at the signage, they'll say, yeah, this is a buy one get one, let me purchase it, and they'll go to the billing counter. They go to billing counter, while they are billing, it is not a buy one get one. The so much amount is been billed. So they'll shout at us, because obviously, right, when I being a customer, if I take that merchandise, seeing that it is a buy one get one offer, when I move to the billing counter, it has been billed MRP. Then obviously customers will get disappointed and they'll shout at us. So that is the major challenges I'll be facing daily, because we'll be cross-checking, but somewhere other there will be a flaws will happen. So this is a challenge which I am facing regularly. So sometimes what will happen, even that is been properly implemented also in the RXL, there will be a problem because of the system that is being that offer is been not updated in the RXL, so that there will be a the offer will not reflect. That is that time I have to talk politely with the customers, and I have to somehow have to resolve those kind of problem like that. So that is a major problem I'm facing right now. So is it clear? Yeah. And the next one is
Manju.
Yeah, ma'am. Yeah, Manju Raj. Ma'am, while local festival, do the department managers decide the discount on the products? No, Manju. So the whatever the discounts and offers will be there in the store, those are being not communicated by us. Those offers will be given by the head office. Those people will be communicated through the mail, and from the mail we have to take the printout, and then we have to implement the offers. So we, the department managers, don't have any rights to give the discounts, and even the store manager, assistant store manager also will not decide any pricing strategies, any discounts or anything like that. He cannot give. We don't have any authority to give the discounts like that. Yeah. Next is Samuel Johns Dara. Yeah, good morning, madam. Yeah, good morning, Samuel. What is the process for performance appraisal? Like performance appraisal, you know, in a quarterly, the performance appraisal will happen. So initially, you need to, appraise yourself. Like, you know, what are all the things you have done in that particular quarter? You need to open your portal and you need to answer that. There will be some questions will be there. So like asking that, what are all the, you know, tasks you have done being a department manager? How much revenue you have been generated? Does your departmental goals are been achieved or not? Questions will be there from the head office, which you need to answer. And based on that, you need to grade yourself first. After that, whatever you grade yourself will be, reviewed by your store manager, and then finally looking at my performance, he'll grade upon my performance, and that will be viewed by the head office people. Then they'll look forward to promote me. That is how the performance appraisal will happen. So Nandan Hegde, which strategy Vishal Megamart adopt overcome from COVID pandemic, and what preparation you made for next Diwali sale? Yeah, that's a nice question, Nandan. So so because of the COVID, what happened is we had undergone our revenue was totally fall down because of no customer entry. So then the Vishal came up with the online selling. So we had tied up with the Swiggy and Zomato people, and we have created a separate website through which the customers have to order whatever the products they want. And our CSS and our staff used to, our CSS and our staff used to pick that products which are being ordered through online. And then we used to deliver those products, and Swiggy boys used to come, and then they used to pick our products and they used to deliver through the to the particular customer. So during the pandemic period, it's very crucial, and after the lockdown is been ended up, the customer started coming, and then the sale was being picked up. And even after the customer entry was done, because of the COVID, there was in the Bangalore, there were rapid, spread of coronavirus has happened. Even now we are talking with the corona patient. So, yeah. And because of that, what we have done is there are strict rules and guidelines that we have been followed. Only one person in a family we had allowed to entry, to give an entry. And each and every person have to wear a mask and have to sanitize their hands at the store entry. No children are allowed during the pandemic period. And we have done masks in the store level, such that in order to maintain a social distancing, so we have made some paths. In that path only a particular customer have to move, and they have to pick the products, and they have to shop in that particular way only. So because there will be a regular BBMP people visit used to be there, and we have to that becomes, usually the sale is a big thing where sale is getting dropped down and no customer entry. Even the customer entry, we have to take care of this kind of wearing the mask and everything. These are all the precautionary measures we used to take in order to get rid of this kind of corona and all, and in order to keep our customers and ourselves safe like that. So this is how we have strategies we have made, and what preparation you made for the next Diwali sale. Dasara, before that, Dasara is there now. From today onwards we have started the Dasara. The feature plan had come, Nandan. So we have to plan accordingly. Future plan in the sense of where to display the merchandises, where which offers have to be given for the customers, like that, which has been communicated yesterday. And today and after your class I need to go and implement those kind of offers on the floor. So it's nice offers you'll be running. Next preparation sale is we have given a target already. Yesterday I have given a target sheet, because today onwards October 1st will start. Yesterday itself I have given a target sheets to all my staff, saying that entire next month the target, entirely day wise target I have been given to my staff. According to that target sheets, they have to cross check whether whatever I am achieving daily is being aligned with the target or not. Because I have given the target sheets, fixture, help cards, and everything is been done. Now what I have to go after your class is just I need to implement whatever the offers that is being communicated by the HO people for the Dasara sale. So good offers are running, Nandan. You can just go to the Darwad Vishal and just have a shopping. So
yes, Shruti. Cheer me.
Yeah, Shruti Nogaja, a very good morning, ma'am. What were the criteria used in your performance appraisal? Yeah, that is what I think I have said for Samuel. Sudha Siddhappa, yeah, I'm here, ma'am. Thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah, anyone? If yeah, one thing, Prema Gotur. Yeah, one thing. Yeah, one thing. Ashutosh Kulkarni, hi, good morning. Hi, ma'am, good morning. Is there anything employees are hired over there on permanent basis, or it is contractual basis in the beginning of the joining of organization. So there we won't hire any contractual employees issue. So the thing is like the once if we are hired, unless if you feel that yeah, it is a good place for working, you can continue. Okay, we don't hire any contractual basis employees like that. So we'll be hiring thinking that so and so particular employee is a permanent employee like that. And if he or she is not performing well, then we'll fire him. That's it. So Prema Gotur, good morning, ma'am. What are the challenges you faced during interview and how you overcome from that? Yeah, interview. It's not like challenges in the sense, you know, nothing like challenging. You have to be confident enough during the interview. So, you know, because by looking at the crowd, you know, when I attended the Vishal interview, so much of n number of students will be coming from different colleges. Can you imagine 230 people attended that Vishal interview and they have shortlisted only 20 people? And by looking at the crowd, we feel that, arey yaar, what is this? Many students are coming from the different colleges. Whether I'll be selected or not, I'll get selected or not, arey yaar, doubt. You should not lose the confidence like that. You should be confident enough that I'll crack this interview like that. The one thing I'll tell you is be confident in what you are doing and be confident in what you are speaking. Please, in the interview, what I'll suggest to you is like whatever the subject knowledge your faculties are teaching in the classroom, try to link that subject knowledge to the practicality. The same thing, whatever the interviewer has asked me, how do you say that retail is an emerging sector like that? The same thing, whatever the Mahesh sir has been said in the classroom, the same thing has been copy pasted over there. So you should have the capability of linking the subject knowledge to the practicality. Unless you should, see guys, I'm telling you, please don't stick towards getting the marks. This marks doesn't fetch anything. So if you score out, that doesn't mean that you are so topper like that. I'm telling you, marks will help you to some extent. Try to expose yourself to the practicality and try to read articles. I'm telling you, read articles and read newspapers frequently. My faculties used to tell a lot, but we being a student, we don't do that. Even I know. But don't do like that. Please do read the articles and magazines and do read the newspapers in order to get yourself updated. So be confident enough while attending the interview, and majorly your grooming standards matters a lot. And now I don't want to discuss about grooming standards because which I've been already discussing a Bharati madam and my sir will always keep on telling you about grooming standards, which I don't want to discuss now. So yeah, that's it, Prema. So Anusha, good morning, ma'am. How would you handle an angry customers? So angry customers, sometimes what will happen, there will be a mistake from our side and there will be a mistake from customer side also. So what will happen is like there won't be any exchange for the undergarments, right? But after they take it out from the those undergarments have been sold out, the customer will come back saying that, madam, this size is not fit for me. Are yaar, there is an exchange policy telling that the undergarments have not been returned once it is been sold out, but those customers will come and ask us to exchange this. Once it has been trialed, we cannot give that particular product to another customers and we cannot take back to that to the floor. But those people keep on shouting, they'll call, you know, like that, they'll become an angry. And so what we have to do? So we cannot raise our voice against the customers, and ultimately customers are our gods. And I'm telling you, no matter how much ever the customers become angry, be polite enough in handling, telling that, sir, no, these kind of garments cannot be exchanged because of the personal hygiene purpose. So if you are already been trial, then that garments have not been trialed. That though, because of personal hygiene, we cannot give that to another customers and we cannot take back to that product, sir. So kindly, even we have pasted exchange policy also, so kindly we cannot expect those kind of. So you have to build a kind of, you have to talk in a very polite manner with the customers, no matter so how much ever angry they become. Okay, and Prema Gowder, thank you. Ashu, thank you. Okay. Akshay Pujari, mm. Akshay Pujari. Good morning, ma'am. What are the strategies of your organization? What are the strategies of your organization to face competition? As we all know, Reliance Retail is getting more strong in this pandemic also. So the strategies what of your organization is facing in the competition? See, in the pandemic, one thing I'll tell you, many stores are being shut down. Even the Big Bazaar is facing a very complicated task now. I think it will get, because of this pandemic, not only Vishal, all retail outlets got, you know, sale was dropped down. We are coming up with the online kind of, these are the strategies we are making up and coming up. So one thing is like competition in the sense of every retailer will do a benchmarking. Let's say Reliance is selling the atta of 5 kg for so and so amount. So we the Vishal guys will try to give a 2 rupees at least below the Reliance. Like that we'll do some kind of benchmarking. Now JioMart is coming up, it's already been set up. So we do the benchmarking which are competitors and try to compete well. So and moreover, you know, Vishal is like more of fashion oriented retail. We focus majorly on the fashion when it comes, because fashion gives us a 60% contribution. We don't much focus on FMCG because just in order to retain the customers, when the customer visit, you know, they have to pick even the FMCG also, the shop or even the FMCG also. So in order to retain the customers, we just kept that department, that's it. But we shall focus majorly on the apparels, where the 60% of the contribution of the store lies on the apparels. So Rahul Balan, good morning, madam. What are the steps you take regarding customer loyalty and how you will make that particular customer stick to your retail shop? Isn't that one challenging facing in any retail? Yes, yes, Rahul, it's a challenging task retaining the customers. So one thing like customers, when customers will retain and when customers will be a loyal. So unless and until they feel that, yeah, so and so product is been available in the Vishal is for a better price and better quality, then we'll be they'll be loyal to the customers. So we'll be putting up a bulk messages we'll be sending to our customers, you know, greeting them during their birthdays and during their anniversaries, whatever feedback we'll be, when the customer visit, we'll be taking the feedbacks and the customer details we'll be collecting near the billing counter. And wishing that particular customers and whatever the offers will be running, that is being communicated through messages, bulk SMSs like that, greeting the customers. And whenever the customer visit, we have to, you know, I'll train the associates to talk them politely and do the a better customer service and give them a better feel that, yeah, Vishal is the best environment wherein I can shop for the, wherein I can visit next time and buy. So if the product, make sure firstly being a department managers and all these managers, we have to make sure the product is been available. Whatever the customer is willing to buy that product, if the customer asks once a product is there in your store, we cannot say that no, this product is not there, this product is not there, no, that is not there. If we say no, 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 then what is the purpose of customer coming and shopping in us? In our store. So we have to ensure the 100% products and stock availability and inventory holding should be there in the store. That is how the customer visit and shop and do better. And Anusha DR, thank you, ma'am. And Akshay Pujari, yeah, thank you. And any other questions?
Yeah.
So related to your career and everything, if you want to ask, just ask, you can ask, feel free to ask, okay? And if you have any doubts regarding your career growth in retail, if you are feeling hesitant to work, so something, please feel free to ask the questions. I'm here to help.
Yes. Thank you, Hemani.
Yeah, thank you, sir.
Yeah. So now I request Prema Gotur to propose vote of thanks. Prema, your voice is not audible. Uh, Unmute your audio.
Morning, ma'am.
Yeah, very good morning, Prema.
Am I audible, ma'am?
Yeah, you're audible.
Hello, good morning, sir.
Yeah, good morning.
So, good morning, all. This is Prema. So, thank you so much, ma'am, for sharing your valuable experience in the college days as well as in the company also. And as a department manager, you taught us how to treat the customers and all. And thank you for sharing your performance appraisal as well as your role and responsibilities in the company also. And once again, I heartily thank you, ma'am. I heartily thank you to my Mahesh sir also. So thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Prema.
Thank you, sir.
Hemani, really thank you so much. Okay, so I really feel so proud and happy. Okay, you spoke so well. Okay, and really you are inspiring. Okay, so I hope my students are really charged up now. Okay, so Hemani, again we'll prefer to keep in touch with you
thank
on
you
the retailing management subject.
Okay. Sure.
So I will definitely
sure, sir. Sure, sure. Always welcome. Please, sir. Please, I'm always here to help out. So please.
Thank
so today,
you so
what
much.
You are here is just because of my faculty. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, Hemani. So I wish you all the best for the day and career. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thank
yeah,
you, Hemani.
Thank you, sir.
You can log out.
Thank you, sir.
Thank
have
you.
A good day.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.